Hello and welcome back to Andromeda. I'm Chance, also known as Ross, and the last episode recording session thingy, I explored Habitat 7, which is not very habitable. I didn't actually notice this crevice. I would have explored up here if I seen it.
Sir!
Stay low.
Hey, Dad. What's up? Interesting.
Who are these guys?
Visitors, just like us. I don't think they're native to the planet.
They're not. We found an abandoned lab, like they've been studying the place.
Good work. You actually did some scouting.
You didn't think I would?
You never know what people are made of. Not until everything goes wrong.
Plenty of that on this mission.
Sir, you said you had an idea about the weather?
Surprised my dad didn't say, "Hey, I'm glad you're not dead, son."
It's affecting the whole planet. Interfering with that.
The tower is caught in a feedback loop with the cloud. Together they're disrupting the entire climate with undirected energy.
It would explain a cave we found. Plant life sheltered from the storm. From that tower.
It's a good bet. And I think if we can get in there and shut the tower down,
the lightning goes away.
And the shuttle can get us out of here, in theory. We just have to get past them.
Alright.
It's a hell of a gamble.
I mean, it's our only shot.
No illusions about this. It'll be a nasty fight the whole way.
If the riders are game, so am I. But we risk turning a skirmish with these guys into something worse.
It's them or us.
Oh, it's them. Problem is, we're outnumbered.
I've been working on that. We just need to change the math.
My dad's planned for everything. The prize! Lightning's a thing now. Let's get rich.
Works for me.
Let's go!
Right behind you. Push ahead to the structure.
All right, my dad.
Sam, load combat profile.
The other side of that door. That looks like a bomb. Can't scan it though. Oh shit. That's a friendly. I love the reload in this game. This shotgun looks great. I love the reloads. Like they improved it in Mass Effect 3, but they did it really good in Mass Effect Andromeda, from what I've seen at least. It literally could go all downhill from here, but from what I've seen, it's amazing. Got some ammo. And scan. Oh. I think there's something to loot here, though. Over here, yeah. I'll grab
Sam,
everything.
Biotic amp interface mode.
Have to keep an eye on our flank.
Not if we keep moving forward. Don't let him catch us.
Yeah, don't let him bunker in. As I...
How's your dad doing all of this?
Completely
like
ignore.
No idea, but it's working.
I don't even see my dad.
And then what?
We'll do it when we get there. Keep up.
hurt.
There he go.
Almost tried me.
Oh fuck. What? Really?
Don't stop. If we fall behind, we're dead.
I thought I would have.
Let's get inside.
You know what? I'm not even mad. I didn't die. Give me this loot. Is that everything? Seemingly so. Nothing hidden.
Sam, give me engineer profile. Little help from Sam.
What does that mean?
Just focus on the fight.
He's cheating because he gets to have multiple profiles.
The storm's getting worse.
That allows him to use everything.
We'll lose our chance if we don't beat it. Come on.
Bastard almost got me. Give it right back to him.
Yeah.
Center. Keep him off my back.
You heard him.
We made it. In one piece. Not over yet. I need to get through that door over there.
Heavy unknown. Kaboom, bitch. Zero. It's red, so I assume it's rare.
There's more coming up!
What's the plan here? They'll surround us in no time.
We need to defend both sides or they'll flank us. Where do you want us?
You?
Right. And you.
Got it! Watch it! Think I see movement!
We held them off at the
three
shuttle.
And
we can do it again.
3 and 5.
A lot of people still counting on us.
I'm just getting warmed up.
They mean business. Keep them off your dad.
Analyzing possible inputs.
Execution shot.
Encrypted.
Hurry, we don't have long.
You don't what? Okay, Korra, I tell you to fight there, and you follow me.
Well,
50% decrypted. It's an unusually complicated syntax.
Come on.
I can see that. Try a recursive search.
I will need a moment to evaluate the pattern.
We only have a moment. Do it.
Liam listened. Damn it, Korra. I tell you to do one thing.
Pissed that one off. Maybe because I shot him in the face.
Sir, any progress?
Encryption is 75% complete.
We've almost got it.
Got your back, Liam.
regrouping for another push. Stay sharp.
Ryder, don't go.
Decryption complete.
That did it. It's a security override. I'll try to open the door from here. Ah, damn, it's jammed. I need to take a look at it.
Oh, shit. It's one of those doors that we couldn't open before.
Put your back into it.
You really think we can shut this thing down?
I don't know yet. Sam's decoded part of the language. Now we'll see if I can have a conversation.
Be careful, man.
Nothing on this planet has listened so far.
Yeah.
Be careful.
Worried about your old man, huh? I won't tell anyone. Come on. These are the moments that make it all worthwhile.
I hope so, Dad. This is the belly of the beast.
Sam, begin translating.
A moment.
Wow.
Indexing. Translation complete.
Like, this technology seems way more advanced than the enemies that we're fighting. The unknown. Because, like, look at it. The enemies we have basic assault rifles and clearly are a military race. But they can't, like, they clearly have not built this. This is something else. Amazing. Look, it's already looking better. It's amazing, look.
I'll be damned.
If you could do that, like,
it's working.
100 more times, we could clearly.
There's hope, at least.
What people need.
That's all anyone back in the Ark is looking for. Hope it'll work out.
Well, not if we stand around looking at sunsets. Let's get back to the shuttle and.
Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, no. Nope. Nope. Up. Oh, we're dead. Oh, no. I don't think her Omni tool is gonna fix that. Oh.
Repeat! We need an emergency extraction now!
They're spinning up the shuttle. ETA is 3, maybe 4 minutes.
Oh god.
We don't have that
long. Oh god. No. No. No, no, don't. No, don't do this. Come on.
Initiating transfer.
Don't. Don't do this! Don't do this to me! This is my one weakness. This is the one thing that makes me cry is self-sacrifice. No! Fuck, I'm actually tearing up. There are tears streaming down my face. Oh no. 4 minutes. 4 minutes. Ah. There's no way. It was one or the other. 4 minutes.
Pulse is weakening. Tell the Ark to prep medbay. Come on.
It was me or him. Fuck. I loved his voice so much. I hate it.
Sam,
I love it, but I hate it.
This implant is overloading. I suggest a hardwire connection.
Do it.
There.
I didn't get it the first time. But the first time I was like, oh, he's breathing. Welcome he's back. Gasping for air because you know what? Look, it looks like the atmosphere is breathable again. And then it's like, no, it's not. That's not what it is.
What happened?
You were in the cave for 22 seconds.
What about the others?
Did the rest of the team make it?
I was dead for 22 seconds.
Hey, you're still with us.
Hell yeah, my boy.
Guys, get to Sam Node. Ryder's awake. Who are you talking to?
Sam. I didn't hear him.
You're up. Look here. And here.
Oh.
My father. Where?
It was your life or his, and he chose you.
Oh, no father can let it.
I'm so
his
sorry.
Son die.
I know this must be a blow.
Didn't know him. That hurts
he
more.
Made the ultimate sacrifice.
Just that we didn't know him that very
got
well.
The team out of danger. We all owe him for that.
He once said that when his time came, he wanted to go out among stars no one had seen before.
At least he got his wish. No one's ever out.
What are we doing
besides
insane,
us
though?
Six, no one's ever actually seen these stars
Sam
before.
Sam is now part of you.
In humanity, at least.
In a way we don't entirely understand. It played havoc with your brain.
Sam?
Your father authorized the transfer of Pathfinder authority to you.
Shouldn't that be Korra?
Yeah.
In theory. In reality, you're the new Pathfinder.
Well. Are
you can't be serious. What's the matter? I think you're up for it.
Thanks, Liam. My bro is like, yeah, you're fine for it, but...
That's easy enough to say. But going out there and doing it? I barely survived that last mission. Hell, technically I didn't.
But you're alive and kicking now. You're not a quitter, that's for sure.
Soldiers...
It's all academic anyway.
Soldier's mind...
Sam's linked to your mind on a deeper level now. Trying to untangle it could kill you. I know this is tough, but... We need to start thinking about the next step. A lot of people are counting on us.
Is the Ark still drifting? That's the thing. Whatever your dad did with that tower, it saved the day. Some sort of atmosphere scrubber.
The energy cloud thinned out. We're on our way to the rally point now. Should be at the Nexus soon.
That's
he
good.
Needs to rest first. He's got 2 hours. We'll need our Pathfinder for this.
2 hours of rest. I just woke up. And I'm already into the breach again.
I checked on your sister. There's still no change. But if you can pull through, so can she.
Hope so.
A bit of your dad in both of you.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to tell her.
Your father will be missed.
What's going on, Sam?
This is our private channel. I shared it with him.
Why me?
Why did he do it? Why me?
Unknown. But he never acted without reason. Alec wouldn't want us to lose sight of the goal. He said pain emboldens our resolve. He'd insist we grow stronger from his passing.
How would we grow stronger from his passing? This part I didn't get because it's like... Most Briarware games is always told from like... the main character's perspective, and then they show this, and it's like, this doesn't seem like the main character's perspective. This is the antagonist's perspective. So whatever. I don't know, I don't get it. It's just like, oh, I guess so? One thing is about these aliens, they all look exactly the same except for this guy. Like in this cutscene, you'll see them all standing next to each other, and you'll be like, wow, there's no differentiating from me either of them. They're all the same guy. I'm assuming like they've gotten to that point in evolution where each species looks the same. Kind of like the Turians Isari and the Salarians were, where, like, their races managed to get to an evolutionary standpoint where they all majority look the same, with very few differentiating. But these guys, completely and utter, they look all the same. See, this point, I didn't get it, because at the first point, the first time I played it, I didn't realize that these guys weren't the ones that made this technology. And this is where I realize that maybe they're trying to do what we just did. Like, they're trying to stabilize the planet so that they could settle, but we managed to do it before them. And now they're pissed because we figured it out, but they didn't. Well, this is, like, that's my guess. I haven't played far enough to actually figure out why. This is what I figured. And yeah, the whole point, like, confused me. It's like, why are you showing me this? Because, you know, I thought we were supposed to be, I don't know.
Ryder.
The BioWare standard.
Good to see you on your feet. We're at the Nexus.
You know, storytelling is usually
shepherd perspective. It's the forward hub for the entire Andromeda Initiative. The Asari, Salarian, and Turian arcs should be there too.
Should.
Let's hope they've had better luck.
Starting our approach now.
It's almost as big as the Citadel back home.
It's based on the Citadel.
Nexus Control, this is Ark Hyperion.
It looks like under construction, though.
Captain, I'm only getting their automated approach channel. Not a live person.
Well, like it or not, we're here. Take us in.
Well, this is no good.
Construction should have been finished by now.
Could be worse. How? Habitat 7's a bust. We might have started a war with the first aliens we met, and our Pathfinder's dead. This better be rock bottom.
Green across the board. Docking initiated.
I don't see any other arcs. Like, if that's the central arc parking place,
I got us here.
I don't see any other arcs.
Good luck, Pathfinder.
Seems Captain Dunn is fine with me being Pathfinder. And Cora's totally on board. You know, when I first saw Cora, it seemed like she was the one that was going to question my authority all the time, but she's been, like, totally chill.
The captain just called me Pathfinder. This is really happening.
Just take a deep breath.
Like, Liam's been cool this whole time, and I expected him being cool because, you know, there's always that one human bro that they have.
You just need to decide what you're going to do with it.
But Cora looked like the kind of Ashley character, and you guys all know my feelings about Ashley. But she's been totally chill so far, which I totally enjoy.
So
I like Cora so far.
This is what we've been waiting for. Let your teams know the docking procedures.
So, you know, that's why I mentioned I'm cool with all the current characters that I've seen so far. I hope there's no Sarahs, because, like, Sarah, I did not like Sarah. She was too much of a I hate the world but love my friends kind of girl. And which I dig characters
nice
like that,
to see some friendly faces.
But she was too much in the thick of, I don't like mages, I don't like elves, I don't like this, I don't like that. It's like, I like all those things and you hate them. Why are you here?
They built a bar, right? Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
You're expecting one?
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
Yeah. I was dead. So far.
We'll bounce back. Real food and a shower are just ahead.
Real food and a shower. Wait, have we actually eaten? I have not seen us eat.
Here we are.
I don't like the look of that right there. Or that. Why is it? It's a bit dark.
I don't see any champagne.
I don't Where see is life. Everybody? Terrarium.
Well, this can't be right.
Brands like everything's on use standby. Hydroponics.
If it's a surprise party, they're doing an awfully good job of it.
Terminal. This is standard Nexus computer terminal design. Interface with wide variety of systems. Seems like things are still under construction.
Plants are still alive.
This looks like what should be a shop.
It's like they didn't finish building it.
Yeah, look at all these containers. Like, this was
Hello?
A form of cover in Mass Effect 2. That's not a terrarium.
This place should be packed with people.
I'm trying to scan that. Not that. That. That's terrarium. Not what I'm trying to scan. I guess that's what's inside the box. Hmm. Well, they got air, clearly. Virtual Kiox, standard virtual intelligence.
Welcome to the Nexus, gateway to Andromeda. I'm Avena, a virtual intelligence designed to assist you with immigration.
They updated her look.
Can you tell us where the welcome party is hiding?
I'm sorry. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations. Please select from the following pre-programmed responses.
Living event arrangements.
Where do colonists live?
Once you've cleared immigration, our helpful staff will assist you in choosing the homeworld of your dreams.
Hmm.
Will it be the tropical paradise of Habitat 7?
Tropical.
The gentle rolling hills of Habitat 3? Or perhaps
tropical.
The mysterious twilight world of Habitat 5? Whichever you choose, rest assured our Pathfinders have carefully vetted all colony worlds to ensure your security and prosperity.
Well.
Oh boy.
Habitat 7? That's where we landed. She's way out of date.
Her data needs to be updated.
What year is it?
The current year is 2819. After spending over 600 years in stasis, it's normal to feel disoriented or confused upon arrival. Our helpful medical staff can assist with any physical or psychological after effects you may be experiencing.
Well, she's got the date right, at least.
So where is everyone?
Yeah. This is like
how does the immigration process
dead zone.
Work?
We ask that you submit to a brief medical exam to ensure your health and well-being after making such a long journey. Once you've been cleared,
hopefully my health is fine.
Experts will assist you in finding your
the Pathfinder.
Home.
I need my health
Please
to
be
spot on.
Thousands of eager colonists like you are waiting to begin their new life in
thousands.
Where? Place is deserted.
I mean, our thousands are kind of taking
what
a nap
tell me
right
about
now.
The Andromeda Galaxy?
Only a few hundred are actually online.
Galaxy.
Really?
This is the furthest any life form has ever traveled outside our home system, making you a brave pioneer indeed.
I'm pretty sure the Quarians
the
left before us.
In a
just saying.
Known as the Helios cluster. Here, you and
to come here.
Of your fellow colonists
so,
will
at least I'm pretty sure they came to Andromeda.
A new home. Fortune awaits.
The Nexus.
What is the Nexus?
The Nexus serves as the central hub for the Andromeda Initiative's colonization efforts. It is the first destination for all colonists upon their arrival in the new galaxy. Please enjoy the many venues the Nexus has to offer. As the station expands, it will one day serve as the seat of government for Milky Way colonists, providing a safe, stable,
but I doubt
and
any more,
environment
like,
is our primary
besides
goal.
Our arcs, I doubt any more
Not
are coming.
From the looks of it.
Based
That's
on
all.
The third game,
it has
just
been
saying.
My Please see one of our helpful immigration staff for further assistance. And welcome to your new home in Andromeda, where the brightest star is you.
Oh, thanks,
Current
Athena.
Current wait time for immigration processing is unknown error.
Right. That was helpful.
That is off, but hey. It'd be worse. We'd be dead.
There's a guy. Maybe
like,
he's
hey.
Got champagne.
Maybe he's got champagne. Hello.
Let's talk to them.
Hi there. We're from Ark Hyperion and wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you? Did you say an Ark?
Yes.
This is the Nexus, right? Pretty sure we parked in the right place.
And for what it's worth, your VI over there could use an update.
Of course, I'm sorry. It's just... we thought you were all dead.
What?
What?
Or captured, or lost in dark space.
We arrived on time, though.
But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
Did we not arrive on time?
I don't believe it.
Ah, sexy Turian armor. Sexy Turian Armor, that's his name to me. Candrus.
I'm Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder.
Liam Costa.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an arc had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
Why?
But aren't you expecting us?
Yeah.
The first arc we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center.
Well, I mean, we arrived on time.
Nothing wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy.
So, a year and a 2 months. We're familiar. Basically, 2 years.
Then you'll know why we call it the Scourge. We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we call them.
Are things back to normal?
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
Well, I'm going to end the episode here. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. Hope to stick around for the next episode recording session thingy. And I shall see you then. Bye-bye. Okay, I messed up. I thought I was like around an hour, but it was actually around 30 seconds, so we're back into the episode.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
No word from anyone, period.
That's bad.
Any threats from the locals?
So far, we've stayed hidden. We're in no shape to deal with an attack.
We had a first contact situation on Habitat 7. Whole thing went south. They tried to kill us.
That wasn't first contact. We know about them. Those aliens are going to be a real problem.
Yep.
This day just keeps getting better.
We're here.
I didn't even get to say what I was going to say.
I'll check out the security situation.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
That's bad.
Is it true?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an arc to finally show up.
Come on, guys. It's only been a year.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
Hello.
The crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
Thanks, Kravitz.
I'm Jaren Tan, director Grandis. Of the initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
Hey. Means, yeah, like, holy shit.
Not as much as it means to us. We had one hell of a time getting here. Nice to see some friendly faces.
Ones are not shooting at us.
Any supplies you can spare would be appreciated.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at him.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Alec is dead. Please understand, the entire initiative is at risk.
I mean, everything's
fucked.
None
of the golden worlds panned out. They're a bust.
All of them?
And there's been no word from the other arc.
There's at least seven of them.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
Oh, shit.
We need to find more resources. But that takes people. And we can't wake them up.
Until they have somewhere to live.
Yeah.
A golden world.
Now more than ever, we need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
But let's hope so.
Well, we came a long ways for nothing if I'm not.
We'll all die if you're not.
That's no way to treat a guest.
Female Krogan! Yes!
I'm Nakmor Kesh, superintendent of this station. I hope they haven't scared you off already.
Nah, I'm fine.
It's nothing personal, but now isn't the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
Yes, we can.
You've heard my concerns.
I'll leave you to it.
Well then.
We're all feeling the pressure. Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a scout ship. I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
She's supposed to be the next Pathfinder, in my opinion. Like, better to talk to
Welcome
her.
Welcome to the Nexus.
Thanks. Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here. What little we can find should have a chance.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is now online.
Let me show you something.
What are you going to show?
An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy.
Wow.
Come see me when you have a chance.
What a way to introduce us to the game. All right, so this is basically where I played up to. After I talked to all these characters, that's in my list of things to do. I wanted to track that. There we go. Basically, I was doing this mission, I talked to three of them, and then that's where I ended it.
What choice do we have? It's good to be. How the hell should I? Alright, what happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec.
He died.
Not how he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
I don't know, he just...
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home.
Calm down.
Not home.
It happened. Deal with
it. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Well, what's
There's
with
also the strange
technology that's everywhere.
Has anyone studied that?
Like 400 years old.
We've tried. Not me. The brains and research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Yeah. It straight up killed him.
You've had no colony successes in over a year. How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The Initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit.
I think
colonies
I messed up and I didn't talk to Sam. Candras.
The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
How do you fit into the
Before
Nexus
I
leadership?
Came over here.
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away.
And well.
And here we are, idling.
You called my
father Alec.
Yeah, Alec.
No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends? Or...
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a Pathfinder until they've path-found something.
Fuck.
Much like a colonial director without colonies.
What's
some kind of plan how are we gonna for deal encountering with... hostile aliens? We can't have been that naive.
What do we do?
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more.
maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder, not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
You guys slaughtered my people.
Excuse me, Director Adams.
Now I'm going to be doing the Ryder? Slaughtering.
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Mm. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
Fuck off. I don't like her. I like Kesh better. Kesh is my homie.
Yes, I know the Hyperion docking unannounced caused some switches to blow. That's fine. I don't...
Shame shit... same shit, different day. For prosperity, in case the initiative goes belly up. The Nexus is a four-ring circus. Don't like how Tan operates, and his disdain for Krogan is obvious. I believe his intentions are ultimately good, but he's an opportunist who likely to create dissent. I don't see the Nexus coming together if he's left unchecked. It's already polarizing Addison. She's taking the cue to circle the dragons. I think I could talk to Candress about this, or at least try to get the two of us in more coordinated. Or maybe not. Seriously, I hate this kind of drama. One thing that wasn't mentioned, because we didn't talk to Candress before we took the shuttle, which is my fault, sorry, is that a good chunk of the Nexus population were exiled because of an uprising due to food, which made so much sense to why there's random pirates in Andromeda. Because me and my friend, we were talking like, oh, there's random pirate humans. Didn't you see the trailer? And it's like, but how? I'm like, I don't know. Maybe some humans made it out here first. I don't know. But now it makes much more sense that they're from the Nexus because they're exiles and they have a disdain for the Nexus because they got exiled from the Nexus. And that wasn't brought up because we didn't talk to Candress, which I'm pretty sure we were supposed to do while we were before we took the shuttle. So I'm sorry, I just wanted to bring that up. Good thing I played this game before.
Others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing.
Yes, there is.
At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
What's your job?
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place.
Nice.
I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible, considering.
Nice. Tell me about the Genophage.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with the Genophage.
Right. The Genophage. A little gift to our people from the Solarians thousands of years ago.
Hmm.
That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
What?
No wonder your people have such a problem with Solarians.
Buttonheads with them.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Solarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Solarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about
It's everybody's fault.
My people need that more
it's
than
everybody's
most.
Fault. State of the cure.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show mutation against the virus.
That's good.
A natural defense. During the
What's your clan's
here,
name?
Krogan
That's a good question.
Gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. It's still early, but I think we made a dent.
That's good.
Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we have. Beyond all 4%. The statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
Solarians made an effective way to neuter your fucking people. What's the problems the Nexus?
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the initiative, Jean Garson, was killed.
What?
What happened to Jean Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders. 10 might know more.
Fuck.
And I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
Sounds like it. Where are the Krogan?
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to Number 8 yet, have you?
Number 8?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made.
What kind of deal?
My clan were supposed to settle matters and in
return... What's your clan's name? I want to know.
...get more say in the initiative.
First things first, tell me why you call him Number 8.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over the Andromeda Initiative. I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
Good.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
Well, what about you?
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Yeah, if you're not here, then they're just gonna slaughter the Krogan out in the Andromeda. I mean, at least if you're here, we could
nothing
convince them to join us
later.
Back later on when everything's not gone to shit. I gotta speak to Tan last, because I think it actually ends this quest. Oh. Actually, further? Yeah, I'll go speak to Cantress and then Cantress and to Tan. What up?
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Pretty
something much. Like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Yeah.
Scattered readings.
Where are
some
the Turians?
Some indicate the Tanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows?
Well, you think we
you
died,
need anything,
so...
Come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Hey, what? Tell me about the Ket.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket?
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Same.
It's rough out there. I might need backup, if you can spare the
when
people.
I played hardcore, I died a lot.
I have strike team specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
That'd be useful.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
Tell me about why you came to Andromeda.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know? Then my sister became a sculptor and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud.
Nyrene?
In service.
I remember.
But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
What's your role?
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards,
I'm right.
Nyrene's
the Turian
like
that
I was in charge.
Appears in the Mass Effect 3 DLC.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
How's the Turians?
Are the other Turians managing okay?
Because aren't they dexterous?
We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets
Turians can't eat human food.
That's probably
and
why
I think Asari can.
Militia. We like to earn
maybe the Salarians, but Turians definitely can't.
But it's hard to focus with our Arcanists.
Maybe that kind of helps their resources.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
I don't know.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
You're the first Turian I've actually seen walking around here. Well, besides that chick.
This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Candris for authorization to participate.
That's the console for our strike teams.
Okay.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex, combat experts who've signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
Trusting me.
I'll deploy your people carefully, Candros.
Yeah.
Appreciate that, Ryder. But trust me, Apex can handle themselves. Authorization complete. Good luck out there.
Cool. All right, I'm gonna choose the longest one because it's already done. This is from, wow, really? This is debrief. Rewards, 5 mission funds. Mission failure? All you guys was you scouted. Scouted. It was just a scout mission. You fuck up. Well then. I guess protect, no. Uncover enemy plans? 5%, oh. Oh, I should have looked at the percentage. Okay. Well then. Fucked up. Fucked up hard. Alright, let's go talk to Tan.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
Yeah, we almost died going in.
That's been true of every world we found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
About time.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules hers.
Does she know that?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself.
To fuck end, you.
The Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it
you
is,
you need me.
Our scientists theorize it's not natural.
I'm the Pathfinder.
An artificial.
It's my duty to figure everything out. You
yet
giving me a
ran
chance
all
is bullshit.
Unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them.
Hmm.
It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
Oh. Eos.
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more
sounds
colonists
like a plan.
We have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
I thought there were 7, but
okay. You said every planet you found is unlivable. So, how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Fuck off.
Right. I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
I don't like this guy.
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off... Maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Cheeky
Where's
fucker.
My ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about that. Ah.
Ouch.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Samnud on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
Okay.
No, I'm fine.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power.
I think I need to talk to him again.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
Okay.
I appreciate it.
About you.
I didn't know him very well. Although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
I'll find him.
They're
Don't
as much
worry.
Part of the initiative as the human arc. We'll find them.
We have to. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Tell me about the missing arcs.
Any more information you can give me on the missing Arks?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian Arks are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst.
We survived.
Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other Arks, the promise of the Initiative can never be fulfilled.
Yeah. Is there anything else?
Other Arks we should expect?
That's
we had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time to come.
Maybe even never.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any hostile threats. Whether that's the
truth.
Cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on sight can be discouraging. Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
The forward station?
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
Fuck you.
It sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds. Many of them our senior leadership.
I guess I could
even
grow to like him. Just right now. First impressions, he said. Fuck you.
How did Jean Garson die?
Yeah.
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Jean Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
I guess it's a lot of weight on his shoulders. I guess being a bit hard, but
criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Sloane Kelly?
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen? Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
We shouldn't have infighting. This is bad.
There don't seem to be
infighting
many Krogan
causes
around.
Good waters.
The Krogan demanded a greater
asshole
say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle, nothing more.
They're people
good
too.
Good for fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
What more can you tell me about the Initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before.
With good
We've
reason.
All left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
What do you know about the early days
of the
Initiative?
I don't think it's gonna happen.
As most everyone knows, Jean Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the Initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
I see.
Why
did you come?
Most people came.
Or, never mind.
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
I'll spot the alien.
It looks
species.
Like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda.
Hopefully it
Though
will.
I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix.
Hey.
As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
Alright. What's your role?
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
What's the gridlock about?
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
What's their problem with you?
Yeah.
I'm not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic.
Exactly.
She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles, some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Revenue management?
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
All right.
Sorry.
Goodbye.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
No.
Of course.
No, thank you.
As you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
All right. Well, I'm gonna end the episode recording session thingy here. I'd like to thank you all for watching. Hope you stick around for the next episode recording session thingy. And I shall see you then. Bye-bye.